Well, hello, I'm Mike Festivo. Welcome back. In this video today, we're actually going to be trying out five different makes and brands of flux core wire, because recently I just realized that not all flux core wire is created equally. Some gives you more spatter, some gives you less. We're also going to be going over tips and techniques. If you're newer to flux core welding, that will probably help you out quite a bit. So stick around, enjoy the video. So I just purchased this Hynade 140 amp flux core welder the other day off of Amazon to test for another video. Trying out this machine, it actually welded really smoothly, but also it came with a little 1 pound spool of flux wire. And as soon as I cut it out of its vacuum sealed pouch, I realized the wire was much shinier and nicer looking than any of the other flux core wires I've ran before. And after welding with it, the results I got were far less spatter than usual. So it kind of sparked the idea of ordering up different manufacturers. Some of the stuff I've tried before, some of it I haven't. So we're all going to be in this together and see what the results are. So here's the five different varieties of wire I ordered. They're all 0.030 wire. This is the Lincoln and this is the Vulcan stuff. Both of these I've ran in the past because they're readily available in my town. These other three I've ordered online. My favorite wires out of this whole group, at the end of the video, I'll put links below in the description, including the link to this welder if you're interested in trying that out. The next stuff is Forney wire. I haven't used this yet. The Yeswelder, I've never ran, but I've heard good things about it, so I'm interested in trying it out. And this is the same Hynade wire as the stuff that came with this machine. So let's cut some coupons here so we can get welding. And we're going to try out the Lincoln first. We're going to be cutting some 11 gauge steel here. So because we have to cut a few coupons for these weld tests here, figure I'll get out my best arc plasma cutter. There'll be links below to this and a few other plasma cutters I found to be super budget friendly and good machines. But right here, I'm actually cutting over this little DIY water table. I'll also put a link below for that video. This was a super simple project and it really makes the shop a lot cleaner by cutting over that. All right, so first we're gonna start off with the Lincoln. It's just in this shrink wrap packaging here. You know, I found that this stuff is kind of glossy, but it also has a little bit of a matte color to it. And I don't know if the wire is just kind of dirty or what. Gonna load this up here and see how it performs. So there's a few cool features about this welder here. It's dual voltage. We're gonna be running 240. And this is your amp readout, and it basically auto sets your wire speed to your voltage. We're going to be running about 110 amps on this, and it feeds really well the way it is. But if you want to ever fine tune it, you can offset your voltage right here to your wire speed. But I found it to work fine just the way it is. So 110 amps, we're going to start welding with that Lincoln wire.
So the first tip with welding with flux wire is that it's actually hollow, so you have to weld at a much slower travel speed than you would if you were using, say, solid wire and shielding gas. So watch your weld pedal closely and make sure you're adding enough wire to build up the weld properly.
Next, we're going to be running this Vulcan 030 wire. It also is in just some shrink wrap. So out of all the flux wires I've ever tried, the Vulcan always seems to be more of a matte gray color. So this is the Vulcan here. This is the Lincoln. A bit shinier with the Lincoln. Vulcan, a little more dull.
So tip two here, this is actually a flux only welder. So from the factory, it's internally wired as a DC electrode negative. This means the MIG gun is negative and the welding clamp is the positive lead. If you're actually welding with a MIG welder for solid wire, that's actually wired as DC electrode positive. So if you actually switch over to flux wire, you're definitely gonna have to change the lugs or the leads so it's set up to be electrode negative. If you don't do this, you're gonna get awful results.
Next, we're gonna be running this Forney wire. It is in a sealed bag, which is kind of nice. Load that up next. Looks pretty shiny and nice. Forney, Harbor Freight, Lincoln. Another thing to mention is this Forney wire is the first wire so far we've tried with the label actually on the outside of the spool when it's feeding off the bottom. It's kind of nice. You can pop open the door, see exactly what size wire you're running. Nice thing.
So tip three is when you're welding with flux wire, you should actually have more stick out than you would if you're welding with solid wire. Stick out can range from 3/4 inch or as short as 1/4 inch. I tend to run about 1/2 inch stick out. So keep in mind with a little bit longer increased stick out, sometimes you'll get increased spatter as well.
Now, I have to say that Forney wire welds a lot like the wire that came with this machine, which impressed me so much. The machine just starts an arc crisp, super clean, just feels very positive the way it's feeding, the way it's burning in. That was a pretty nice wire. We'll see what the results get when we clean all these off. So, we're going to try the Yeswelder out. Again, it's in a vacuum sealed pouch, which is a nice touch. No moisture is going to get in there or anything like that. And it's got a little bit of paper wrapped around the outside as well. Nice and shiny looking wire.
So there's a saying with flux, and that is, if it's got slag, you drag. So always pull your flux wire, never push it. This will help not incorporate flux inside your weld, which can lead to porosity. Big machines shielding gas, you can push or pull, but with flux, always pull it. Just consider this when welding with stick or flux wire.
Felt pretty smooth, felt similar to the Forney wire. So last is the Hynade wire. Comes in a pretty basic package, doesn't even say Hynade on it, so we'll see. Oh, another vacuum sealed pouch. Says Hynade on the inside. It's got the wrapping like Yeswelder. Nice and shiny. So we'll load this up and see the results.
So flux wire, just like stick welding, has a tendency to be more forgiving when it comes with rust or dirty metal than MIG welding. To get the best welds, you should still consider cleaning all your weld joints with an angle grinder and a flap disc. Clean off any rust, paint, or other grease or dirt before welding. There's a saying, if it's worth welding, it's worth cleaning first.
So that was pretty cool. I've been interested to try out how these wires stacked up against each other. These are T-joints, so each wire, basically I went down one side of the joint and then turned it around and welded the other side. We got the best foot forward, basically the best joint we got out of each of these wires here. And before we clean off the smoke and spatter, I want to bring you in so you can get an idea of what each one of them look like. All these spools are 2-pound spools besides the Lincoln. That's a 1-pound. And the Lincoln, by far, even though the spool is cheaper, pound per pound, the Lincoln's the most expensive. I'll put a list on the side of what I paid for each of these wires, and there'll be links below to them. So I'll bring you in closer so you can get a nice view of what the results look like. I would say out of these wires, 3 of them welded very similar, but 1 of them welded smoother than the rest. And it just felt crisper and nicer to weld with. And I was kind of surprised. For the Lincoln, I noticed a few bigger balls of spatter on this one, the most I've seen on all of them. Smaller spatter on this one than the Lincoln, but very similar looking coating of the flux on here. It's a very small spatter across this and very even weld all the way across, and the flux coating over the top of it sure looks different than the Vulcan and the Lincoln. A little bit lighter colored smoke on this one. This one didn't have too much spatter across it either, but a little bit different changing in the flux covering on here, but that doesn't say much until we get it cleaned off. But it welded pretty smooth. A little bit more spatter here than the Yeswelder, but it welded really consistently. Nice crisp arc. So first test we're going to do is we're basically going to lock down each one of these coupons, go over it maybe 10 times with the brush, see how much slag comes off and how many of this little spatter comes off of here. And then after that, we'll get out a wire wheel on the angle grinder and clean them all down really nice and take a look at the end results. All these coupons here have about 10 to 12 wire brushes on them. Got some flux here, still stuck on here, cleaned up a little bit. The Harbor Freight actually cleaned up the best with the 10 to 12 strokes of the brush. Forney has a lot of the flux still on it. Yeswelder, about 50-50 cleaned up. The Hynade still has a lot of flux still left on it. So we'll put a wire brush on an angle grinder, clean these up, and take a look at the results. When it comes down to the BB spider on here, it's got some on the Hynade. Yeswelder doesn't have too much. Forney doesn't have too much. Vulcan has still quite a few big ones on there. And Lincoln doesn't have very much. Most of the little BBs, there's a little bit stuck on here still, but most of it came off pretty well. Cleaned up really nice with that wire brush on the angle grinder. Pound for pound, like I said, this stuff's the most expensive wire here, and I didn't really like the way it burned in. I mean, it looks completely fine. I think it's a nice solid weld, but running it with the machine, it didn't feel as crisp as some of the later wires we used. This one by far had the most little BBs still stuck on here, even after going over with that angle grinder wire brush. It burned in okay, like they're gonna be completely strong welds, but again, it didn't run as smooth on that machine. The Lincoln and the Vulcan just doesn't run as smooth. I kind of notice this every time I've always ran this and always had a lot of spatter on there. It works, but it's not my favorite. Really almost no spatter left over. Very consistent bead, nice and strong, but this wire ran really smooth. It sounded probably the smoothest on the machine. It stood out from the rest. Very smooth wire, really pretty consistent. Not really any leftover spatter on here after taking it down with the wire brush. Worked pretty good. So here's the Hynade. Keep in mind, this is what kind of sparked this idea of me doing this wire test, because this stuff works so good in the machine I got. Pretty consistent, a few little bits of spatter on here, but not much. Welded pretty smooth. All right, so my final results and feelings on this wire, we're gonna go from worst to best. And the worst has to be, and I've used this wire for years because it's readily available, is the Vulcan. It seemed to leave kind of a inconsistent weld bead, didn't feed in the machine as well. Inconsistent flux coating on the outside, and the most spatter out of all the wires we used. I've been using it for years just because it's readily available, but I've never really liked it, and I don't do much flux welding anymore, but in the past when it's all I could afford before I had MIG machines and gas bottles, I did a lot of welding, and I used that or the Lincoln stuff, and my feeling on this to this day is it's not very good wire. Next wire I didn't care for that much is the Lincoln. It's the most expensive pound per pound. Fed very similar, reacted very similar to the Vulcan stuff. It seems like similar specs on wire here. A little bit better consistent bead profile, a little less spatter, but it's still not that great a wire. I have not been happy with it. With that being said, it leaves us with these three. Now, the reason they're all in a row is because it's really hard to decide which one is actually superior over the others. They all seem to be a cut above the Vulcan and Lincoln stuff. The Forney, I have to say, felt like it ran the most crisp and smooth on the machines, but barely more crisp than either of these two. All these wires ran really smooth on the auto set on this machine. The Forney wire just looks like it maybe melted in a little bit hotter, even though it was the same amperage, because the bead profile is a little smoother and soft. These two have a little bit more shape to the bead profile. Nice, super strong welds on here. So I would say the Forney has pretty minor amount of spatter. The Yeswelder and the Hynade are all pretty equal, but any three of these wires, I think you're going to be happy with. Like, I'm going to keep some of these on hand. Now, one other thing is I'll break down the price on the side and see which ones are the most affordable. That might be a little option on the side here. But the Yeswelder, I have a 10% coupon promo code down below. So if you use Mike Festiva and the Yeswelder site, you get 10% off everything. So that might be a reason if you're buying something else from that site to maybe put one of these in your shopping cart. The Hynade, I don't know if I can get a coupon for that. If I do, I'll put it down below for an Amazon coupon. The Forney, I've never talked to that company before, so I don't really know if I have any promos. I don't think it was that bad a price though. So all these wires will be linked down below, the good wires, not the Vulcan, not the Lincoln, but just these front three wires will be all listed down below in the description if you want to order them. I really don't like the Vulcan and I don't like that Lincoln, and I've always felt that way about those wires, but they were consistently something I could buy right in town, go to the local store. These ones I had to order online, but it's well worth just keeping an extra one, order maybe two, and keep them around, especially if your main machine is a flux unit. This thing also comes down to dialing your machine precisely. You get your volts and your wire speed set, and this thing's all auto set, this Hynade 140 amp dual voltage machine. And all these were left on 110 amps, ran all the way through, very consistent. This machine auto set works unbelievably well. So there'll be a link to this machine as well in the description if you're interested in trying one of these out. Probably the best price going on flux welders at the time of this video, they sell for $149. Can't guarantee they're always going to say that price, but out of all the many little portable flux welders, this is the only one that I've ever seen that's a dual voltage machine. So it packs kind of a lot of value with this. So hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing, and leave a comment down below. Till next time, thanks for watching. Bye.